you. The more I drink, the more I think about you. And the more I can take. Maybe every place I go reminds me of you. Thank you. Maybe you've taken my shit for the last time. Yeah. Maybe I know that I'm drunk. Maybe I know you don't want. Maybe. Oh, cause girls like you, my rama guys like me, so now when I go through, I need a girl like you, yeah. See, because we're all so close, yeah, we're all best friends. Now's the time when we go off stage and then we wait for you to cheer and then we come back out. We're gonna skip all that shit. Because we know there are certain songs that we have to play, that we love to play for y'all. And let's be real, we all know that we're not gonna leave until we play them, so why bullshit you? You know, the encore used to be a different thing. It used to be, I'm gonna go off stage, I'm finished, and like maybe they'll be so fucking excited that we'll come back or something. I know. We're coming back anyway, so it doesn't matter. So I think we should start a new trend at concerts. No more encores. Just play it as long as you want. That way, when it's over, you're like, everybody knows it's over. And I was like, James Valentine on guitar, everybody. Looking like a 70s teenager. That's your vibe. Is that just exactly what you were going for? Well, you nailed it. You look like someone from fucking Scooby-Doo, man. And I mean that in a nice way. Because I like Scooby-Doo. It's a great program. All right, guys. Where are my ladies this evening? Hello. Hi. How are we doing? You know, this song we wrote about 17,000 years ago. And it was about one person. And I'm very, very happy that over the last 1,700 years, the song has taken on a meaning to so many different people, and that makes me so happy. It was the first song we ever wrote where we felt like we really had a song that the whole world was going to sing, and I think it's a pretty cool thing when it actually happens. You know,
So, and it never would have been able to happen without you guys making it happen. So we love you for that. And I think, it's my favorite, one of my favorite ones to sing. It's called She Will Be Loved. Amazing and also not chill. Then when I hear those crazy screams, you know, like, so, yeah. It was very specific. It was like, who was it? I can't, whoever that was, listen, whoever that was, you sound like fucking Axl Rose. You should get in front of a band. Amazing. It's impressive. But seriously, shh. I'm just kidding. You scream all you want, dude. Okay. Just to clue you guys in on a little musician thing. That, when James goes like this, that's not just him doing a cool thing. What that is, that's a language he's speaking to me. And what he's saying when he says that is, hurry the fuck up and start to sing again. Now, sometimes I like to respect him and continue singing, but sometimes I like to make him, keep him on his toes. Okay, that I promise you. Fine.
Tap on my window, knock on my door. I wanna make you feel beautiful. No, I tend to get so insecure. Doesn't matter anymore. It's not always rainbows and butterflies. It's compromise and moves us along. Yeah, my heart is full of my thoughts. Come inside, you are, yeah. I don't mind spending every day out on the corner in the pouring rain for the girl with the broken smile. Ask her if she wants to stay a while. She will. Nothing at all.
feel beautiful. We'll be right back.
Baby,